Assalamu alaikum and hello to everyone to today's tutorial video about converting electrical circuits into PLC electrical connections. We're only going to consider the hardware aspects and leave aside the programming aspect. So first, we're going to look at this electrical circuit sample. And it's good to have some background on what you're going to do. But we are going to convert this electrical circuit into a PLC electrical connection. And for that reason, we need to identify the inputs in this electrical circuit. So we have here three inputs. And we have one single output. So the inputs could be either push buttons, set buttons, proximity switches, electrical switches, limit switches, and the outputs could be solenoids, bulbs, buzzers, so on and so forth. And it's very important to bear in mind that not all components are going to be considered for the PLC electrical connections, since we are going to omit all the relays as well as the relay contacts. So this is a very important step. To omit all these redundant components. And this is how the PLC electrical connection would look like. So since we have decided we have three inputs, we can only see three inputs here. 1, 2, 3. And since we decided we have one output, therefore we have one single output here. Make sure that your PLC is always energized. You have your positive and negative power supply, as well as make sure that if you have a proximity switch that has three terminals, a positive terminal, a negative terminal, and as well as the signal terminal, that only the signal terminal should be connected to the PLC, whereas the negative terminal should be connected to the zero voltage supply, and the positive terminal should be connected to the 24 volt supply. Looking at a second electrical circuit sample, we have increased the complexity of the electrical circuit. However, things are still easy and simple since we have a limited number of inputs. So we have the first input here, second input here, a third input here, and we have increased the number of outputs, so we have three outputs in this circuit. So as we have explained earlier, we need not consider these relays or relay contacts, and this relay as well, and this relay as well. So we are going to omit all of these components. And in fact, these components are being omitted in the electrical connection of the PLC. However, they are considered in the PLC programming, which is not our topic for today. So in the program of the PLC, whether it is an FBD program, or whether it is a ladder program, or whether it is a graph set program, then those omitted components should be considered, as these components will provide the logic of the circuit. And this is how the PLC electrical connection looks like. So we have three inputs, 1, 2, 3, and three outputs. Quite simple. Moving to the third electrical sample, and here we have a bit tricky question, and this is mainly due to this input, which is made of two poles, and I'm going to return to this in a while. So we have a second input here, a third, fourth, fifth, sixth input, and we have four outputs, one buzzer, three solenoids. Again, we have to omit all these relays, so we're not going to consider them for the electrical connection in the PLC diagram. However, they are considered in the programming. So back to the first input, that is quite tricky. And due to this tricky input, we have yet to decide whether we have 6 or 7 inputs. So if we consider this to be 1, then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 inputs. However, if we consider these to be 2 separate inputs, then we will end up with 7 inputs. So I think you have guessed it, this is a limit switch that is labeled as S1. It has only a single label since it is mechanically linked as shown by this dotted line. So this is one pole of the limit switch. This is the second pole, or the other way around. This is the first pole and this is the second pole. The first pole is normally closed and the second pole is normally open. So the question is, do we need to consider them both or one of them? And it is up to us. We can either consider this or both of them. And I'm going to show 2 solutions. This is the first one where I have considered both of the inputs to be separate. And each input has been allocated to one PLC terminal. And this is a really fine solution. So we have total of 7 inputs. Or else we can, okay, so we have the inputs and outputs. Or else we can have the input omitted here. So we have omitted the input, one of the poles of the input. So we still have the other pole. However, we need to consider this omitted input in the program of the PLC. So inside the PLC program, we need to consider this input which has been omitted, and we can replace it by a NOT logic. So if this is normally closed, and the other one is normally open, and we have omitted the normally open, so we can actually simulate this in the program by providing a NOT logic. And the NOT logic, if it is a FBD program, would look like something like this. So you have a black dot here which shows a NOT. So if you send a signal of 1, you get 0, and this is what basically the 2 poles do. If you send 1 here, then it is 0 here, and if it is 0 there, it is 1 here. Anyhow, that is the programming part. As for the PLC electrical connection, this connection is good, as this is good too. So I hope that this short tutorial is helpful, and hope to see you next time.